good. So number one, listen to me. Don't write this down. It's not a principle. Listen quickly. I'll give you the first principle. Number one, this is not the principle. It's going to be a dog fight. I would love to tell you that on the road to success, everything is going to work out. It's not. It's going to be a dog fight. It's going to be a dog fight. For those of you watching my videos, on the road to success, I lost 5 aunts to cancer. It's a dog fight. In the midst of my business, I lost aunts. I had to go to funerals. We had to get on a plane. We had to drive. We had aunts that are close to my age who died, who didn't have insurance. We had to raise money. A dog fight. I had cousins shot in stores, execution style, shot back of the head twice. It's a dog fight. Like, you don't see that on YouTube. You don't see that on my TGIF. It's a dog fight. My wife, 3 years ago, 7 lesions found on her brain. It's a dog fight. It hadn't been easy. It's a dog fight. It hadn't been, the road hadn't been success. Like, it's just a paved road. And like, each he go this way. It's been rough. It's been crooked. It's been hard. But I've made up in my mind that I will get a reward for the pain that I go through. I will not stop in the middle of the process. I will not be defeated. I will not be destroyed. I will take everything that happens in my life and I will allow the pain to push me to greatness. You will not break me. You will not stop me. You will not defeat me. The only way I lose is if I quit. It's going to be a dog fight. And so if you're ready to quit, then don't get started. If you're ready to quit, don't get started. If you're looking for this easy path, don't get started. If you think they're not going to close the door on you and say no 1,000,000 times, don't get started. But every time they close the door, I just get excited. Why? Because I am not a no. I'm 1 yes away. I'm young. I'm 1 yes away. You can't keep telling me no forever. You can't keep denying me forever. This type of energy, this type of passion, you can't stop it. You can contain it for a while, but you cannot stop. This is life. And you can't defeat me. You don't have enough power. You don't have enough energy. You don't have enough strength to stop this. Contain it for a year, you might. 2 years, you might. You do not have hate, does not have enough energy to destroy love. You cannot destroy this. And so I'm telling you today, it's going to be a dog fight. And the sooner you realize it's going to be a dog fight. Okay, so let me just say this to you. So in America, right, and I'm sure it's the same thing here, but they're in our armed forces. Let's just pick one. The Navy, for instance. We just pick the Navy, right? Well, let me tell you guys, this is good. Listen to me very closely. The first thing they teach you. Somebody over here, help me out. You are in the Navy, right? They're teaching you war. Right? What's the first thing they teach you? Boot camp. The very first. Somebody tell me over here. Just take a wild guess. What's the first thing they teach soldiers?
Courage.
Good. Courage. Okay. This side. Discipline. So give me something practical. What's the first practical thing that they would teach you? Say it again. Defending yourself. Somebody over here. How to swim. Listen to me very closely. The first thing they teach you. The very first thing they teach you. Is how to respond when you have a jam gun. And number two, how to carry a dead body. That's the first thing they teach you. They don't teach you how to defend yourself. They don't teach you how to swim. The first thing they teach you is when your gun is jammed. The first thing they teach you is a dead body, how to carry a dead body. And somebody tell me, why would they start you there? That's the worst case scenario. That's what you're not prepared for. That's what you're not thinking. You're not thinking when you go out there to defend yourself that your gun is going to jam. You're not thinking when you go out there that your boy going to get killed and you got to drag. You're not thinking that. So listen to me. It's not hardships that hurt us. It's not my cousin getting shot twice. It's not my cousin spending 50 years in jail. It's not my aunt dying of cancer. It's not my wife being diagnosed with 7 lesions on her brain that will break you. What will break most people is you didn't prepare for that. So when you put all your little goals and all your little dreams together, it's not the thing that broke you that broke you. It was you never even thought about the fact that you could be broken. You never prepared. You never prepared for worst case scenario. And the reason why E.T. is standing here, because I prepared for it. If you know anything about me, I still lay on floors. I still eat chips off the floor. I still do some stuff that to most people is crazy, like, E.T., why would you do that? Because I'm always prepared that we may not live in that house one day. One day something might happen and we might have to go back to that. And if I have to go back to that, it's not gonna break me. And so I present to you a diamond. Most women love them. And most men spend a lot of money on them. I'm gonna say it again. Most women love them. And most guys have to work a long time to be able to get a nice one. The thing we covered the most, and that for a diamond to be produced, it must first go through extreme heat. Extreme heat. Extreme pressure. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? For a diamond to be produced, it has to go through extreme pressure. Extreme heat. And if that wasn't enough, what makes a diamond is the cut. So you are put through, if you want to be a diamond, you must go through extreme pressure. If you can't take pressure, then you're not a diamond. After you go through all the pressure you thought you could not handle and you think it's over, then they turn on the heat. Of all the stuff I've gone through in my life, eating out of trash cans, sleeping in abandoned buildings. The worst thing that ever happened is when I went to the hospital and they told me my wife had a chronic illness and she might not be able to walk one day. People say, E.T., ask CJ, it never broke me. Why? Because I've been broken so much. I've been defeated so much. I've been disappointed so much in my life that I know what it feels like and I can handle it. It didn't happen to me at 19. It didn't happen to me at 20. It didn't happen to me at 30. It happened to me at 40. After I had been through all the pressure I thought I could go through, life said, you finished with all the pressure? I said, yeah. I said, let me bring on the heat. And then when I went through the pressure and the heat, y'all, I thought it was over. The Creator said, now you ready to get cut? You say you wanted to be great, son. You say you wanted to travel the world. You say you wanted to help people, inspire people. Then you gotta be a diamond. But listen to me very closely if you've ever studied the diamond. Once it goes through that type of pressure and it finally becomes a diamond, at that point you can't break it no more. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? Once you get to that point, you cannot be broken anymore. And the only way they could tell if a diamond is a diamond or if it's fake is by applying pressure is how they tell. They don't just look at it. You think you just look at the thing. Like I looked in the thing. They'll just bring it here. Bah, put it on some glass. Bah, okay, it's real. So I'm being honest with you. I'm not giving you the seven principles to. I'm trying to tell you the very first thing I want to tell you before we go through the principles. It's going to be a dog fight. And if you soft, this ain't you want to get out now. This is where you're like, I quit. But if you're willing to say, I'm not going to quit, I guarantee you whatever success you want to have, you're going to have it. All right, so here's number one. I apologize. It took a long time to get to number one. Number one, Denzel Washington, you must be very intentional and deliberate. You must be very intentional and deliberate. The stuff that you wrote down on that piece of paper is not gonna happen by osmosis. You're not gonna wake up one day and find a law degree. You're not just gonna walk out of your house, oh, there it is with my name on it. I'm a doctor now. It suddenly appeared. It's not gonna work like that. If you're married, it's not gonna, if you're married, I promise you, I've been married over 26 years. If you're going to have a good relationship, you're going to have to work for it. If you have a business, you're going to have to work for it. If you have a healthy relationship with your children, but I've made up in my mind that nothing's going to stop us from having a daily relationship. I will do whatever it takes, make whatever adjustments I need to make. So it's going to be a dog fight, but I'm telling you from personal experience, you don't have to start with anything. I'm a living example. You don't have to have anything to get started. Not even a daddy. No, I'm being real with you. Not a bank account. Not a name. Not a camera. We didn't have a camera when we first started. Not even business cards. We still don't have business cards. People say, how are you so successful with our business card? I don't know. We just say, here, take our number down. If you're serious, it's here. Here's my number. Call me. So number one, you need to be very intentional and deliberate. I'm going to give you three, four things. I'm letting you go. The first one is you need to be very intentional and deliberate. And what I mean by very intentional and deliberate is, please, you have to hear this. I believe in rugby that both teams are professionals, correct? Listen to me. Both teams are professional. Both guys have, you know, started young and are, they all have, you know, are all, you know, physically able to play the game. But what happens is you have one team that's good in spurts. You have another team that's dominant. Come on, come on. Hear what I'm telling you. When I say I need you to be intentional and deliberate, hear me. I want to paint the picture. You have one team that has the ability to score. They have the ability to do well. They have the ability to score on the opponent. What their challenge is that they can't do it. They can't sustain it. The teams that are dominant, all black, dominant, because they can do it from beginning to end. Right? Listen to me. And they can do it team after team after team. Right? They can do it over and over and over. They dominate because they put pressure on you from the time you start to the very end. Like, oh, even when they're up, they continue to dominate. And your problem is you're not intentional and deliberate. You wake up on Monday, you might be strong, but by Wednesday, somebody told me, E.T., it's Wednesday, it's hump day. I said, I thought every day was hump day. It's hump day. I thought Sunday was hump day. I thought Sunday is where you really get started. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? You're not intentional and deliberate. You are hoping that the best is going to happen to you, and the best never happens to you. Listen to me very closely. As a Christian, I remember going to God and crying out and saying, I'm doing all the right stuff. I'm doing all the right stuff. I'm not hurting nobody. I'm finding folks' wallet, and I'm finding a way to get their wallet back. I'm not disrespecting females. Like, I'm trying to do all the right stuff. Why am I broke? And God said, being a good person, son, has nothing to do with making money. That's absolutely, you're a good person, and you're going to be rewarded for that. Ask CJ, I can lose my computer, and somebody's going to send it back to me. I lose stuff all the time. I'm like, all right, I'm not going to lose people, but I'll lose stuff. It's like, it's not that deep. Listen to me. I'll leave money, not even in a wallet, just money sitting there. And I'll come back and somebody said, did you lose some money? I'm like, it didn't even have my name on it. Like, I'm being honest. The Beats by Dre, I left them on the plane the other day, did some work, came back. I just randomly walked up to 48, exit gate 48, randomly just walked up and said, I lost some headphones. And he said, oh, are they black with red? I said, yeah. He said, I think that they're down in the security. I'm like, security? That's 2 miles from here. I got to catch a plane another 15 minutes. He said, oh, I'm sorry. What's your name? I said, Eric Thomas. He said, oh, they're right here. We're talking about in Los Angeles, California. I randomly walk up to a gate, and this guy just happens to have my... So God said to me, good stuff is always going to happen because you're going doing good stuff. Money's not going to come to you because you're not doing money stuff. Come on, you got to hear what I'm telling you. He said you got to be intentional and deliberate about money stuff. You got to create a product that people need, and you got to give it to them regularly. Like, thank God on Monday for the last 8 years, you just got to keep giving it to them. And the first year, nothing. The second year, nothing. The third year, a little something. The fourth year, a little bit more. By the fifth year, boom, you're a household name. You got to be intentional and deliberate, whether you're making money or not making money. You got to decide that you're going to do something, and you got to do it every Monday, every Tuesday, every Wednesday, every Thursday. The problem with some of you in this room, you're not intentional and deliberate. You're a good person that just hopes the good stuff is going to happen to you. So you need to be on Facebook, because Facebook, they're not just good people. They do the analytics and tell you who's watching your stuff and who's not watching it. They give you the numbers. Hear what I'm saying. If you are intentional and deliberate. So I wake up every single day. See, I don't care what country I'm in. I don't care how long we've been on the flight. I don't care what our schedule is. 2:30. What time do I wake up every day, see? Okay, when we were in Poland, what time did I wake up? Okay, what about England? What about Australia? Are you hearing what I'm saying? I'm intentional and deliberate. I don't care what time zone we are. I just sent my family to time. I'm in New Zealand. I'm looking at what time it is at home and said, yesterday. I said, yesterday? I like this. I need to be a betting man. I said, it's yesterday? Negative 18 hours. And I'm still getting up at the exact same time. CJ, did we work out since we've been here? Yep. We just finished working out. How long did I run on the treadmill? Nothing changes. Nothing changes, guys. I'm very intentional. And some of you could be so, you'd be so much better if you just didn't leave things a chance. Eric, what are you saying? I thought you were a man of faith. I am. Faith without works is dead. They kind of go together. Faith works. Not one of them by themselves don't work magically. You can't work your way to it. You can't faith your way to it. It's a beautiful blend of faith. I believe the plane is going to land in Australia, but I still got to get on it. Oh, faith. I believe that people are going to show up. Like, we're taking a chance. We don't know if people are going to register and come. We're here. We're in Melbourne. We're in Brisbane. We're in Perth. We're in Sydney. We don't know that people are going. I brought my wife. If I crash with my wife, that's it for our leg. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? So faith is great. We believe we're going to get here. We believe things are going to work out. But I still got to get on the plane. I still got to land. I still got to work out. I still got to do TGIM. We still got to do the podcast. Like, nothing changes because I'm in a different country and I'm in today or tomorrow. I'm literally in tomorrow right now. Need you to write this down. How can you be more intentional and deliberate about your life? And when you get home, you're going to answer it for me. All right, two more things. I'm going to let you guys get out of here. I promise. I need you to be intentional and deliberate. Do we do the podcast at a different time every week? Same time. Do we do Thank God It's Monday on Wednesday? As a preacher, do I have my services on Thursday? Same thing every. Come on, guys. I'm not trying to make this deep. I'm trying to make this as simple as I can. When you leave this room, you're going to go to a whole nother level. A year from now, 2 years from now, 3 years from now, Denzel walked in and said, 16 seconds. Principle number two, he was aware, heightened sense of awareness. You need a heightened sense of awareness. Some of you are making the same mistakes over and over and over and over and over and over and over. I need you to have a heightened sense of awareness. When he walked in a room, before he moved, he studied. And many of you in this room, you are moving and then studying. And you keep making the same mistakes over and over and over and over again. Come on, hear what I'm telling you, making the same mistakes over and over and over. And I remember crying, why are these guys, motivational speakers, traveling all over the world? And I don't get to travel all over the world. I'm trying to do right by people. I'm speaking all over the world. What's going on? And as I did my homework, I said, oh, Eric, you're doing something wrong. You are motivating and they're empowering. You're just telling your story, but you're not making the connection between their life and your story. There are no principles. You're not principle driven. There's not enough content in that. I didn't cry or complain. I just looked at my life and said, E.T., you need to make some adjustments. But that only happens when you have a heightened sense of awareness. So do me a favor. At least an hour a day of every day, you need to be reflecting on what you're doing good and what you're not doing good. Now, we can break that up if you want to. If you want to break that up into 20 minutes in the morning, 20 minutes for lunch, 20 minutes at night, you want to do a half hour in the morning, a half hour at night, I don't care. I just don't want you to make the same stupid mistakes over and over and over again and call it life. I don't want you to keep doing dumb stuff and say, my life is miserable. No, your life is not miserable. Your reflection time is miserable. Your ability to edit, to make adjustments, to make corrections is messed up.